Hi everyone, this is Charlie Berluti and welcome to the program, Cross Paths. Tonight we have a guest with us who's a real nice guy, who is a great painter, and I think he's done much for Newport. His name is William Hayter, and we call him Bill. And Bill has done a couple of books, plus many, many other books on landscapes. But the two specifically we're going to talk about is the first one he did was Newport and People. That was his first edition. And what it encompasses is many people in the Newport area. Now, Bill has often said, it's not that the people are important, it's just that the way he picked them out in various ways of life. And the most important one he put out is called, as of this moment, is Newport and People Too. And I'm going to show you that right now. And welcome to the show, Bill.
Thank you, Charlie. Thank you for having me back.
Bill, tell us about these books that you did.
Okay.
Tell us how you came about doing them.
Well, the first book started by just painting friends and family, and it's evolved into this book of portraitures.
Mm-hmm.
And it was successful. A lot of people enjoyed it. After I finished the first book, I decided to do a second one where I'd reach out to get a more of a variety of people around town, not necessarily people who were more important than anybody else, but people who just created, added to the liveliness of living in such a great city as Newport. I hope I live long enough to be able to paint everybody in town, because everybody who lives there deserves a lot of credit, especially in the wintertime when the town kind of becomes more of a closer family and you really get to enjoy so much of the ambiance we call Newport.
You're right. In the summer, everything just goes wild. You have
crazy
people from all over.
Right.
But like you said, in the winter, the city brings itself together.
That's correct.
And you see people that you haven't seen in a while.
Right.
Familiar faces. You might know them, not know them, but you know the faces.
Right.
And you've gone a step further. You've taken the step to go out and meet them and know
right
them, and in some cases, paint them.
That's right.
And I've been through both of your books, plus your watercolors, and you've done a tremendous job.
Well, thank you very much. I brought with me, this is from the first book,
uh-huh,
and I just thought we'd start off because Jim passed away recently on his motorcycle, and he was a great guy, and it was a wonderful portrait. He was very excited to have his portrait done, and I just thought we'd start off by a little tribute to Gimpy, that we're sorry that he's not with us anymore.
Well, you know, when the last time I saw him, he was up at Dunkin' Donuts, his favorite
right
hangout,
yep,
and that's where you portrayed him.
That's right.
And at that particular time, he was doing, believe it or not, wheelies.
Yeah.
Out
yep
in front of Dunkin'
yep
Donuts. And he often talked, I know he talked about, to you about this, about traveling from one part of the country
right
to another.
Yes.
And he never did achieve that. But
no, I think everyone is a little concerned about that, such a great effort. Doing that all by yourself, you know, would require a lot of luck and good fortune on a bike that he kind of like held together with, you know, tape and, you know, what he could do.
It was so funny that one time he called me over at Dunkin' Donuts and he said, hey, I want to show you something. He unzipped his leather jacket. Underneath it, he had a trophy. And he says, this is one of many trophies that I have won.
Wow.
And what he did do is, I didn't know it, he had like on back of a truck, like a portable garage that he used to put his motorcycle in, and he used to polish it up, clean it up, and fix it up.
Wow.
And he's quite a guy.
Amazing guy. We're
yeah
going to miss him a lot.
That was in book...
That was book number one, Important People.
Uh-huh.
We can start off, the interesting thing is we can start off on book number two, because when I was here talking about book number one,
uh-huh,
I got to meet you, and
oh
one of the first portraits I did in book number two was you and Bob.
Uh-huh.
So, and that's the old set with the, I don't know where the globe is, but...
I think the globe is over in the corner somewhere.
Okay.
Yeah, You did a great job.
You try to capture the expression.
Bob and I have done a lot of shows together.
Yeah.
And we've had many good times.
This is a portrait I did of Keith Stokes
at
God's Little Acre, which is on Farewell Street. And he is helping preserve these tombstones, these headstones. And this headstone is a Violet Hammond. And it says, the wife of Cape Coast James, who died September 1770 at the age of 20 years. And a fantastic guy. And again, trying to capture people in a an environment that they feel is important to them.
He's done a lot historically.
Right.
So he's doing a great job, too.
And we go from something like that to...
Oh, yes.
The Mary Salas and her two sons, Jose and Junior, in their restaurant. And just a lot of fun, a great family restaurant. And again, wintertime, having a little pasta up there, it's nothing better.
I was up there, my wife and I were up there about 2 weeks ago.
Right.
And it wasn't bad. I mean, usually in the summer there's a lot of people.
I was going to say, you're lucky to get in.
But we caught it just right. I guess it was around 5:30,
okay.
Something like that.
Yep.
And we got in there, and like you said, the ambiance was beautiful.
Beautiful.
Was not
and
many
she's
people
always
in it.
Walking around, shaking everybody's hand.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very pleasant family.
And then again, in this second book, I tried to reach out to get a variety, and these are some of Newport's bravest at Station One.
Uh huh.
And it's everybody that was there, and we set up the shot and. Girls are slowing down in their convertibles and yelling out that they had a fire to follow them.
Oh, God.
It's quite humorous.
My son-in-law is a fireman.
Okay. Oh,
and he's in Station One, but not on that shift.
Oh.
And he has a son, of course, my grandson, who wants to be a fireman. And he's always out there, and you go over to his house, and he puts his raincoat on, and he's got this helmet. And he puts these rubber boots on, and he's got this little piece of hose, and he goes going around putting out these fires.
That's great.
He wants to be just like his dad.
Well.
So it's quite a tribute. I think we've got one of the best fire departments around.
Yep. I agree.
Oops.
This is Lewis and Nicholas Paris Condolo. And they run a fish dealer depot down at the Perry Mill Wharf.
Uh-huh.
And they've been there forever. And again, these things are going on around us. People are hauling fish, people are trucking that, people are fire department, the restaurants, it's just...
You know, a lot of old Newport is disappearing.
Yeah, yep.
I know you're not a native Newporter,
no.
But you've seen a lot of changes since you've been here, too.
Well, I try to capture people, not necessarily as native Newporters, but because you could move here a week ago and contribute to the community.
Exactly. You're right. Exactly.
And here this woman moved here from Sweden. She's a yoga instructor. She's with my daughter, Bernadette.
Mm-hmm.
And...
We had her on a show, I think, Kristen...
Yeah, Zetmar.
Yeah, we had her on a show one day, I think,
yep.
And she was very, very good. She, I don't know if she does massages or not, but she
does massages. She also does this amazing weaving images on